Hi, welcome to Kalpana's kitchen. This is Dhiren, her son today over here. We are going to make garlic bread today. I learned this recently at one of my courses that I'd gone for, outdoor leadership course. And we made this bread in the jungle using very basic ingredients and cooking materials. We have a lot of stuff over here, so we'll try and make it as authentic as a jungle over here. But yeah, let's learn how to make garlic bread. And these are the ingredients. The ingredients are, we'll require some white flour. We'll require 2 cups white flour. 1, 2, and 1 cup wheat flour, 1 teaspoon baking soda, baking powder, just to be sure, 1 teaspoon yeast, 1/2 a teaspoon of salt, some garlic and water, and I'll be mixing all of the garlic. Just make small discs. We are going to add it to the dough as we mix it. This will give it a nice flavor when it starts to cook. There is no particular number of garlic cloves you require, just eyeball everything. So before we start kneading the dough, first you need to get your hands clean. Okay, so first wash your hands properly. Now with your clean hands, okay, we're going to start adding water to this in the center. Okay, and we're going to mix it slow and steady. Okay. No, we are not using any oil, butter or anything. So the trick is to add water slow and steady so that you can get a good consistency. Otherwise, if you add a lot of water in the beginning, then you will get a lot of lumps and you will not be able to mix the flour. The initial part is just like clay work, so be sure to like have a lot of fun while doing it. And yes, I think you at some point need to stand up to put in more pressure. Now you are getting some consistency of it. You take the ball and make sure to add a lot of Once you have this dough nicely kneaded, okay, we are going to let it sit so that the baking powder and the yeast in it gets some time to act and make it a little more fluffy. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put it in a airtight container over here. I have this dabba. I'm going to put it inside the dabba and we're going to wait for about 15 minutes or half an hour. And then after half an hour, we will bake. Alright. So now we have kept the dough in an airtight container for about half an hour, 35 minutes. Okay, let's see how it looks. It has risen a bit. Okay. Great. We are going to take a slightly thick, deep dish pan. Okay, and start to heat it. And we're going to line the dough with oil. And now we're going to make small balls of this dough. Okay, and then just place them. Go. don't have to have a particular size as such. You just round about that size. Now we are going to cover it and let it cook on the pan.
On high?
Little high.
Medium.
Medium?
I don't know.
Let's see, I haven't tried it on a home flame. So, in the forest we are using some whisper-like stoves. The gas, as in the flame below, it was a little mild at our area. Let's see how much time it takes to go to cool this. So, it's been about half an hour since we put this on a slow flame. It's fluffed up, you can see the size of it has gone up. I'm going to open it now. I'm going to just put in some butter on top. Color you'll get if you have an oven, because when there's a flame or heat from the top. But right now you won't get a color from top because there's no heat source on the top. So let's let it cool it a little bit, then I'll handle the bread, then I'll show you how it looks on the inside. I'll just take one of the breads out and cut it and see how it's become. A little burnt on the bottom, but it's
okay. That's okay.
Okay, then from close. Can you see?
Yes.
It has risen properly. Let's try and taste it. Not bad. So friends, we saw how easy it was to make bread even if you don't have an oven. We did this in the jungle. Right now we managed it on our regular heat pan in the house. It's easy to make bread and do try this at home. If you like this video, don't forget to press the button like, share this video, put in your comments, and keep watching Kalpana's Kitchen. Till the next time then, bye bye.